all the vehicles in the Imperial Guard arsenal, one is feared above all others. Not for its impenetrable armor, nor for its terrifying armament, but for what it represents, the Lehman Russ battle tank. A brutally simple machine, capable of running on the simplest of liquid fuel, the Lehman Russ exemplifies the true strength of the Astra Militarum in its numbers. Wave after wave of Lehman Russ armored formations crush any enemy resistance, while more technologically advanced foes are overwhelmed, outflanked, and destroyed. This overwhelm, not outperform philosophy is reflected on the tabletop in the Lehman Russ's relatively low points cost. A standard Lehman Russ armed with a battle cannon currently costs 145 points, meaning that seeing 6 to 8 tanks in the standard 2,000 point army list is not uncommon. On the tabletop, this means opponents with very powerful, expensive anti-tank weapons won't be able to effectively neutralize your army, as they can't engage more than one target with a single weapon. Lehman Russ tanks, however, are quite well armored for their rudimentary design, with over 150 millimeters of frontal armor. On tabletop, this translates to a 2 plus save and a toughness of 8. Lehman Russ lack an invulnerable save, however, making them vulnerable to high AP weapons like Meltas. The main armament of the Lehman Russ varies widely, as many different variants are used by the Imperium of Man for specific purposes. The most common variant uses a battle cannon, a simple, well-rounded weapon that excels at taking down enemy heavy infantry or armored units, with D6 shots, an armor penetration of -2, and D3 damage. In the Demolisher variant, this battle cannon is replaced with a Demolisher cannon, an extremely high-caliber weapon designed to bombard enemy lines at close range. The Demolisher deals much more damage than the battle cannon, with an improved AP of -3 and D6 damage at the cost of a severe decrease in range, from 72 inches to 24 inches. The next variant, the Lehman Russ Executioner, mounts a giant plasma destroyer capable of tearing apart the most heavily armored of targets. Though the standard stats are underwhelming, overcharging the plasma cannon can double its damage output on the tabletop. While overcharging plasma weapons can lead to malfunction or fatal explosion for more lightly armored combatants, overcharging costs only a single mortal wound for each unmodified hit roll of 1, due to the Executioner's emergency vents and heat shielding, which mitigate most damage. The Lehman Russ Punisher, however, trades armor penetration for rate of fire, mounting a Gatling cannon that can shred hordes of enemy infantry. On tabletop, this translates to 20 shots at strength 5 with no AP. The Gatling cannon also suffers from a short effective range, limited to just 24 inches on the tabletop. The remaining three playable variants see comparatively little use on the tabletop, but I'll briefly mention them. The Eradicator mounts a Nova Cannon, a devastating weapon effective against dug-in infantry in urban, dense environments. Though on tabletop, the Nova Cannon negates the saving throw bonus provided by cover, its stat line is overshadowed almost entirely by the standard battle cannon-armed Lehman Russ. The Exterminator variant, armed with twin-linked autocannons, is effective against lightly armored Horde infantry, but, both in lore and on the tabletop, is overshadowed by the more widely produced and more efficient Punisher, with its devastatingly effective Gatling cannon. The Lehman Russ Vanquisher carries a long-barreled Vanquisher battle cannon, which is extremely potent against enemy armor, but suffers from a low rate of fire. As such, on the tabletop, the Vanquisher can do a devastating amount of damage if the shot hits, but the relatively poor ballistic skill of guardsmen makes this weapon too unreliable to be effectively used in most armies. Keep in mind that most Lehman Russ tanks cannot effectively engage enemies at point-blank range with their long-range, high-explosive weaponry. This is reflected on the tabletop in the blast keyword, which means that these weapons cannot be fired in melee combat. Ensure you keep long-range Russ variants far from enemy units that could tie them up in combat. Notably, close-range variants like the Punisher and Exterminator don't have such weaknesses, and are thus free to be used in close-quarters combat to devastating effect. Lehman Russ can also carry heavy bolters, plasma guns, flamers, or multi-meltas in sponson mounts, and a heavy bolter, flamer, or las cannon in a hull mount. Lehman Russ formations are led into battle by skilled tank commanders who ride with battle-hardened veteran crews. On tabletop, these tanks have their own profile with unique stats. These tank commanders only cost slightly more than a regular Lehman Russ, but enjoy an improved ballistic skill of 3+, while also gaining access to powerful tank orders that can drastically increase Lehman Russ firepower. Gunner's Kill on Sight, for example, allows a Lehman Russ to reroll once to hit, while Full Throttle allows a Lehman Russ to move again during the shooting phase. Knight Commander Pask, a formidable Cadian Lehman Russ commander, is famed for commanding the legendary Hand of Steel that took out a Chaos Titan with a single shot. In game, Pask has an incredible 2+ ballistic skill and can issue 2 orders per turn, at the cost of 30 points more than a normal tank commander. To represent the varying combat tactics and characteristics of individual tanks, Lehman Russes can take a Tank Ace ability at the cost of 1 command point at the beginning of the game, which improves their capabilities in some aspect. Steel Commander, for example, allows a tank commander to issue an additional order per turn, while Weapons Expert increases the armor penetration of turret weapons. Lehman Russ tanks are the backbone of Imperial Guard armored regiments and should almost always be included in a competitive Astra Militarum army. A balance of good firepower, decent armor, and low cost make Lehman Russes a threatening prospect for an enemy to counter, formidable enough that they can't be ignored, but inexpensive enough to field scores of them. Please let me know down in the comments what vehicle you'd like to see next on the series, and thank you all for watching. Until next time, Cadia stands.